Well, the big news this morning coming out of Gujarat, suspended IPS officer Sanjeev Bhatt's wife Shweta Bhatt will be contesting against Gujarat Chief Minister Narendra Modi from the Maninagar constituency in Ahmedabad. Sanjeev Bhatt's wife will be contesting on a Congress ticket against the BJP leader.
Sanjeev Bhatt is displaying this whole act of fighting Narendra Modi, but his whole act is politically motivated. And today, by Shweta Bhatt contesting from a Congress ticket, all that I said on news has been proved right. His fight was a politically motivated fight. And everybody and anybody who knows the political reality of Maninagar knows that Narendra Modi is definitely winning. But this particular move by the Congress party reflects, one should reflect on two issues. One, that Sanjeev Bhatt always fought a politically motivated fight against Narendra Modi. And two, that there isn't a single leader in the Congress party who has the courage to face Narendra Modi, because they know that citizens of Gujarat stand by the Chief Minister. So since they are aware of the fact that their defeat is definite, I think they have played this card. But I think anybody who knows the political reality of Gujarat, and especially Maninagar, knows that Narendra Modi's victory is definite. You know, for Congress, everything is symbolic. Congress promised that in 100 days, they will control price rise. Did they? They did not. Congress promised that in 100 days, they'll wipe out unemployment from the entire nation. Did they? They did not. Congress promised that there will be industrial growth in the country. Was there any growth? There was not. In fact, to take symbolism to a new height, the Congress party, just to defame Gujarat and Narendra Modi, used a photograph of a malnourished child, a flood victim from Sri Lanka, in a campaign against Narendra Modi and the BJP in Gujarat. So when you talk about symbolism, my question is that will Congress ever fight on facts and reality? The very fact that the Congress is running away from a debate on governance or from a debate on development basically highlights the fact that the Congress actually does not have solid ground to work from in Gujarat. Everybody in this country has a right to fight a political battle from any ticket that they deem fit. But my question with regards to Sanjeev Bhatt is something that the Congress party will have to answer. Time and again, one asked, why is it that Sanjeev Bhatt is taking blackberries from the Congress leaders? Time and again, one asked, why is it that Sanjeev Bhatt directs Congress leaders and workers in a district to put up posters against Narendra Modi during the Sadbhavna mission? And that the Congress leaders in that district were working on directions of Sanjeev Bhatt. All those questions that I asked repeatedly for 1 year have been answered today when Shweta Bhatt openly stands on a Congress ticket.
आज संजीव भट्ट जी की धर्मपत्नी मणिनगर में नरेंद्र भाई के खिलाफ कांग्रेस का उम्मीदवार बनकर वो चुनाव लड़ रही है. इसका मतलब ये हुआ कि बहुत दिनों से गुजरात में कांग्रेस जिस तरीके से सीबीआई का उपयोग कर रही थी, जिस तरीके से कांग्रेस इन ऑफिसरों को उपयोग करते हुए गुजरात में एंटी गवर्नमेंट जो एक्टिविटी हो रही थी, उसमें आज पूरा पर्दाफाश हो गया है कि आज उनकी पत्नी कांग्रेस के उम्मीदवार बनकर वो प्रजा के सामने आ रही है. दूसरी बात, कांग्रेस को भी कोई नेता नहीं मिल रहा है. कांग्रेस का लोकल अहमदाबाद का कोई नेता नरेंद्र भाई के सामने लड़ाई लड़ने के लिए आज कोई तैयार नहीं हुआ है, इसलिए करना पड़ा है.